New evacuation orders have been issued overnight as the rain continues to fall around the New South Wales coast. Let's take you to Jackson Browne of the Bureau of Meteorology now. The Bureau, Jackson, has warned of life-threatening riverine flooding in parts of Greater Sydney today. Which areas are in most danger?
Look, we've seen quite a bit of rainfall around the Sydney area. We've seen up to 212 millimetres at Dora Creek. Now, the east coast low that has been driving that. Most of the action has moved on into the Hunter, but we could see some of those falls still affect the Sydney Basin. But irrelevant, regardless rather, of whether the rain's still falling, we do have major flood warnings for the Hawkesbury Nepean. We saw major flood at Menangle overnight, which exceeded the floods of last year. And we have peaks expected today at North Richmond and Windsor, which will also exceed the flood levels of March 2021.
Yeah, I mean, these poor people were only dealing with this situation a year ago. So could these floods be worse than the floods we saw last year?
Exactly. That's just what I said.
Oh, apologies. How much worse?
Look, so for example, we saw around 13 metres last year at Windsor. We're likely to get up to around 14 metres this year. So it's exceeding it, but not by a terrible margin.
Okay.
We saw a lot of rain even ourselves yesterday. Rainfall of up to 200 millimetres in 6 hours was predicted for Sydney yesterday. Did that eventuate?
I wouldn't focus on the minutia. I don't think these 200 mils in 6 hours was fully realised. What's more important is the cumulative totals, and overall, all of this water is getting into the catchment and resulting in those major flooding and the evacuation orders.
And what about southeast Queensland, Jackson? What can they expect today?
I just can't catch a break. Just more bad weather on the way. We saw some pretty intense thunderstorms overnight. Saw falls of 39 millimetres in 15 minutes, or 66 in 30 minutes. So giant hail out at Inglewood on the Queensland-New South Wales border of 5 to 6 centimetres. The soils are saturated. There's absolutely no margin for this water. So any sort of moderate to heavy rainfall will result in flash flooding. And it's likely, just given the amount of thunderstorm activity that's forecast over the next couple of days, it will lead to renewed river rises and impact the active recovery.
Oh, we're really hoping that it stays dry in Lismore and Ballina right now. Will that be the case?
Most likely not. We will see some thunderstorms get down in there. So we're looking at severe thunderstorms with the risk of damaging winds, heavy rainfall and large hail. But, you know, they will extend into northeast New South Wales. The areas to the north of Brisbane, up to around the Bundaberg area, we're looking at high-end thunderstorms. So destructive winds, giant hail and intense rainfall. So it's not good news for people in southeast Queensland, northeast New South Wales, but we just got to beat to the weather's drum sometimes.
Yeah. And how long will it last? Where's the East Coast low headed next?
East Coast low, thankfully, looks to wash out mostly by this evening. So it'll wash out into a trough, so stop becoming such a major focus. However, there will be a lot of onshore flow with showers still persisting, but not in those sort of 200 millimetre mark, biblical rainfall amounts. And for southeast Queensland, northeast New South Wales, we've got storm days today, which is the main day, and tomorrow. And then we still have a action of a cold front which sweeps across New South Wales, which will keep the rainfall ticking over till about Monday.
All right, Jackson Browne at the Weather Bureau, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.